Okay, this silhouette cutting video goes along with the Make a Card Monday, I Love You With All My Heart. So if you want to see that card that, you know, comes from this silhouette cutting design, go ahead and click the link that's on your screen right now. It'll take you straight to that card video. So we're going to be creating this piece right here. It's the card base and then additional paper pieces that go on top of the card. I'm going to walk you through it step by step. The first thing you need to do is make sure you're using the most current up-to-date Silhouette Studio software. You can do that by going to silhouetteamerica.com and then going to the support page and looking for the software download. Okay, so I'm going to start with a new document. And how I like to work in the software is with a little bit of the carrier sheet revealed. So I usually come over here to the side and take it down to about, oh, I don't know, somewhere in the 50s. That's usually where I like it. Okay, we're going to first create the card base because that's what everything else is based on. So I'm going to come up to the rectangle tool. I'll select that and I'm just going to draw a rectangle. I'm not paying attention to the size because now I'm going to select that rectangle by clicking on the red line and coming over to the, what is it called? The scale window. And down here at the bottom, it allows you to change the size. So I'm going to make it a standard size card. So I'm going to put the width as 4.25. and the height is 5.5, and then I'll hit apply. That makes it the size of card that we want. Okay, now I'm gonna draw an oval for the top curved shape. And I'm just gonna draw an oval, oh, about like that. I'm gonna bring it over here, and I also need to make sure that that is the correct width. So I'm gonna come over here and change it to 4.25. I'll hit apply. I'm not that concerned about the other, like the height of it, because I can go like this and it kind of changes how extreme that curve is. That right there looks right to me. I'm going to click and drag around both of these shapes so that it selects both of the shapes. And I come up here to this, what is it, the align window. This is a new window that they've added to the software, so if you don't have that in your software, go ahead and download the updated version. I'm going to go to align left. And it just pushes that oval over to the left edge of the rectangle so that they're aligned perfectly. I'm also going to have it align top so that we can do some adjustments. Okay, here we go. I'm going to select the rectangle and I'm going to pull it down to about halfway down the oval. And then I'm going to click and drag and select both. And I'm going to come to the modify window and I'll hit weld. And that just puts both of those together. Okay, now I'm going to go to the, align window? New. It's a new one. It's the replicate window. And I'm going to have it duplicate right. I'll click that and it makes it perfectly to the side. So now we have the front and back of the card. And before we weld these two together so that they cut out together and we can fold it, we're going to do some additional pieces for the front of the card. I'm going to come up here to the offset window. And I'm going to do an internal offset, and then over down here at the bottom on this little slider tool, you can adjust how far inset it is. I'm going to have it be right there. This, I'm totally eyeballing it. I'm not making a specific measurement. Okay, and I'll hit apply. And now with that still selected, I'm going to go ahead and do internal offset again. And I'll bring that in just a little bit more, and I'll hit apply. Okay, the sticker that we're working with, it's from American Crafts, and it has the sentiment on it, and I want a piece at the very bottom of the card to be the perfect size for the sticker to go on top of. And the sticker happens to be, I'm just going to draw a rectangle, and we'll change the size so it's specific. And it is 2.75 by 1.375, 1 3/8, and I'll hit apply. Okay, so now I'm going to put this down right here at the bottom, about right there. And we're going to have this top piece as pattern paper, but the bottom portion is going to be a different piece of pattern paper, and they're going to intersect underneath a ribbon. So I'm going to draw a rectangle here, and you'll see what I'm doing here in a minute. It looks a bit strange, but I'm just going to draw it way larger than it needs to be. I have about right there. I'm going to select that box, and then also the internal curved shape. Holding down the shift key, I'm going to select both. Actually, before we do that, we're going to select the curve shape. We're going to do Control C or Command C if you're on a Mac. That's going to copy it. And then we're going to do Command F or Control F for paste in front. You can also get that up here in the edit menu under paste in front. Okay, with that selected, I'm going to select the larger rectangle we just drew. we're going to come to the merging palette, and we're going to do intersect. And that what it does is it cuts the two shapes into one shape wherever those two are intersecting. So I'm going to click that, and it makes this perfect rectangle right there. So now we have all the pieces we need. I'm going to go ahead and delete this one because that's the sticker we already have. I'm going to select the two curved rectangle shapes for the card. And I'm going to come to the weld selection right there, and that makes the card base. So the way you want to cut all of these pieces, I'm going to select those together and move them off the page. I'm going to come up here to this icon right here, which will make it look like the page and the mat again. I did that because you'll notice it's still a little bit on the mat and it might cut that, and we don't want it to. So we're going to select them and move them off to the side some more. Okay, so now I would come up here to the cut window, and I change the settings for the whatever paper I'm using, and then I'd cut the page. I like to just cut everything at the same because most of the paper I cut is cardstock or pattern paper, which is a little bit thicker. So I usually use the media as cardstock, the speed 3, and the thickness 33. That is the default setting for heavy cardstock. So go ahead and hit cut to cut my page. And once that's cut, you can move this piece off the mat. And then you can move each of these pieces in individually. You can cut them all together if you're comfortable putting your pattern papers and your different pieces on your mat in different locations. You can cut it all, or you can cut them separately. So that's how you come up with the design for this card. And hope you guys enjoyed. And please check out the video where I assemble all the cards together. Thanks for watching.